Welcome to Reality Create a Video. I'm Hermes, and you think you know what's good for you, huh? Today, we're going to make zinc, colloidal zinc, finally. We're getting around to it. Silver is the easiest to make. Zinc winds up being the next difficult. Okay, so basics of making colloidal zinc. You are going to need zinc rods. Two of them. 99.99% zinc rods. You can get them on Amazon. At least that's where I got mine. They will last a long time. And zinc isn't too expensive. So, yes. That's the first thing you're going to need, the zinc rods. Next thing you're going to need in order to make zinc is a chemical to make the process go faster. Zinc is a very slow cooking thing. And I've thought about how to present this to you in a way that many of you guys do not have the equipment that I have in order to create colloidals. So I wanted to do this in a way that you can create zinc without having to do the tremendous expense. Because the easiest way to create the zinc is naturally by weighing the rods, seeing how much material has gone off it. But if you don't have that, I've made a chart which deals with how long to cook the zinc for. And so if you follow the chart, you'll have a certain percentage of solution along the way. This is a 40 parts per million zinc solution, and this is a 15 parts per million zinc solution. So we're going to have to create what's called a stock solution using sodium citrate. Now, this stuff isn't going to go to waste. So you'll use it with copper as well. And you also use it with gold. So you're going to have to mix about 7 grams of sodium citrate in 500 milliliters of distilled water. That's what this looks like. This is might have been used mine, so it's definitely not full. So this solution is going to be needed to make the zinc, the colloidal zinc. So you're going to fill your beaker. Now, this is a small beaker, 250 milliliters, and the only reason I did that was because I have a whole lot of zinc here and really didn't need to cook too much zinc. So I use a small beaker. The time it is that it says for 200 to cook to 15 or 20, 10 or 15 or 20 milliliters, whatever time it says, just double that if you've doubled the amount of liquid. Don't use any heat. I use heat because it makes it go faster. All right, but if you don't have a heated stirrer and you can't measure the weight of the rods, you're not going to know how much zinc you have in the mix. So I've tried to make this as simple as possible for you. So don't use any heat. It's going to take longer, but at least you'll know what's in there. And the tricky part, okay, of the zinc, the extra that makes it a little bit harder, is you're going to need a current meter. Something that's going to measure in the milliamp range down to 1 milliamp. This is my current meter. Any one of the current meters will work. And what you're going to do, watch that meter while you drip. The sodium citrate into your mix. Now, if you're using the regular, you can use the regular silver rig that I had showed you that was my original rig, but you need to have the aerator in there. You need, with zinc, you need to have the air currents going, or you need to have some kind of a stirrer. You just need to have the stirrer in here spinning around. Right now, I don't have any water in here. So you're going to drip in the top of this thing, one drop at a time. You can use an eyedropper. This is a pipette. But you're going to do that. You're going to drip one drop at a time, and you're going to watch the meter until it reads 3 milliamps. Don't let it go over 5 milliamps. Ideally, you want to keep it between 3 and 4 milliamps of current. And then the chart will be accurate. I mean, the further you go away from 3 milliamps, the faster it's going to cook and the less accurate the chart's going to be. So try and keep it around 3 milliamps. Cook it for that length of time that's on the chart to get what you want. Now, this is a 40 parts per million chem solution. The 40 parts per million solution starts to look a little milky white. I know you really can't see it here. They all look kind of clear. This one has a very slight milky white thing to it. If you're cooking your stuff and all of a sudden your stuff starts getting milky white, you're reaching around 40 parts per million. You don't really want to go any higher than that. I would use 40 parts per million for topical stuff. I would do the 15 parts per million for taking internally. Now, as I've said before, zinc is great when mixed with silver, colloidal silver. I don't have silver around to show you. Oh, yeah, I guess I grabbed the silver out of the thing. What the hell, right? So there's my big jug of colloidal silver. What I like to do with the zinc these days is mix 20% zinc, 80% silver. But you can do zinc on its own. Zinc is a great health booster. It helps your body heal faster. So if you're getting over injury or any kind of injury or illness, zinc will accelerate the healing process. And colloidal zinc also makes you feel great. It's not like regular zinc. I've taken regular pill zinc, chelated zinc. Colloidal zinc just makes you just take some zinc and it's like you just want to zone out. That's why I call my zinc, I don't know if you read it, but Zen Master. Because you take this stuff and, man, you just want to zone right out. So, really, that's the most difficult part about zinc, is that you're going to need to measure, keep the current around 5 milliamps. Now, you can cook zinc without using this, okay? I cooked this one. This one here says zinc 15 parts per million, no chem. What I did was I wanted to see if there was a difference between the zinc using my sodium citrate and the zinc using nothing. And I'll show you the two pictures in the microscope between the two of them. They're virtually the same outside of the one with the where we use the sodium citrate has a little bit more medium particles in it at 15 parts per million. That's about the only difference between them. So, but the big difference is the amount of time it takes. Now, I am not even measuring time with no chemicals, you know, with no sodium citrate. But I will tell you this. This 200 milliliter jar took me almost 4 hours to cook to 15 parts per million. So if you're going to do 500 milliliters of zinc with no chemicals, you're looking at 6 hours. Cooking time at room temperature, not using any heat. When I first started cooking zinc, I used to just set it up and go to sleep and then cook it. The problem with that is you have no idea what it's going to be, how much you're going to have in it. Outside of you cook it up to the part where you start to see the light haze in it, then you know you're sitting at 40 parts per million. Now, I've drank 40 parts per million zinc. It's fine. Nothing wrong with it. So, but I would say because it's such a, I would say that this is probably better for topical, and the 15 is probably better for drinking. But, you know, experiment. Maybe you'll find that, you know, the 40 is better. So, I mean, sometimes I overcook zinc, and so I'm drinking. I'm not throwing it away, so I'm going to drink it. This one here is probably about 20-something, okay? Because, like I said, I've overcooked some zinc lately, and I've had to mix it down. So I'm probably taking about a little over 20. But zinc is always friendly. I love zinc. So that's basically it. That's how you make zinc. You'll have to invest in a multimeter if you want to do it properly. And you can follow my chart. For those of you that have a scale already, a three-digit scale, you can measure your rods every 15 minutes until you get to the parts per million that you want. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.